descriptions of dry bones, valleys of skulls, and the stench of Lazarus' dead body. The psalmist cries out from the depths of despair, "Lord, hear my voice." Each year, our Lenten journey takes us here to the brink of despair. We are guided here each year by the liturgy of the church because we, as people of faith, and indeed as human beings, need to be reminded, need to see and hear and feel the suffering of Christ Jesus and the suffering of his world. Each year during Lent, we are asked to take a spiritual journey, a journey to the cross, a walk through that valley of dry bones, the valley of the shadow of death. Same walk that Jesus took so many years ago, the one that led him to the cross. This morning's text from Ezekiel is one of the most imaginative and dramatic stories in all of Scripture. The prophet tells of the hand of the Lord coming upon him and setting him down in the middle of a valley full of bones. Now, before I go any further, let's just stop right there and imagine that for a second. Can you imagine being plopped down in the middle of a valley full of bones? It is a pretty grim vision. One of horror movies, not one we expect to find in Scripture, but also one that is real to many in our world today. Consider the refugees fleeing the awful and terrible violence in the Middle East. For millions of people in Syria, death and destruction are very real. I'd just like you to picture for a moment what someone in that situation is experiencing. The worry of being shot any time you leave the walls of your home. The constant search for food and shelter. The loss of any ability to provide a living, to keep your family safe. And the grief and despair of loved ones lost. In our world today, there are refugees fleeing war in Syria, fleeing through boats, leaky boats across the Mediterranean, fleeing over land and many borders to Turkey, and all across Europe. There are refugees crossing the border right here in the U.S., walking through deserts in the middle of the night to avoid the day's heat. And there is the violence that we see in our cities. Violence of gangs, of gun violence, the violence of the needle of drugs. And there's the violence of displacement from natural disasters and from climate change. There is the violence and the grief and the sorrow from the lack of jobs and poverty, from lack of opportunity, from lack of education. You see, and I'm sure you all know too well, despair takes many forms. The people of Israel were in despair over over their exile in Babylon. They had been marched there against their will, their leaders in chains, their cities in ruins, their temple destroyed, and they themselves forced into slavery for a brutal dictator. Ezekiel witnesses the soul of his people gradually withering and dying, becoming as lifeless as a valley of dry bones. Our hearing of this scripture again today, thousands of years later, is our call to listen to the cries of God's people in the world, to not turn our backs, to not turn a deaf ear to the world's suffering. The inclusion of this story during the fifth week of Lent is a reminder to listen and to empathize with all those in our world who cry out in pain. It is also a reminder to look inside, into our own lives and our own communities, to find those places where the bones of our spirits have dried up, where we have lost all hope, to focus on the places in our lives, in our own churches, where our bones are dry, where we have died and need new life. Ezekiel's vision is given for a people who have lost heart, who are suffering a death of the spirit, a living death in exile in a foreign land. This vision is held up again today when so many in our world have had their own experience of dry bones. Our earth has been fashioned into a massive graveyard of dry and lifeless bones. The spiritual death that poverty and natural disasters and war exact from people reduce them to this state. Many are feeling this utter desolation. Particularly here in this country, the undocumented, those with green cards or non-permanent status in this country, suffer that pervasive fear that has been sown in our immigrant communities over the last several months. Even for those whose status is legal, the situation can feel very desperate, even hopeless. So what is your valley of dry bones? What is your tomb of despair? What grave clothes are binding you? Where is the stench of death in your life coming from? Where do we see that stench or those dry bones in our churches, in our world? Is it the loss of a loved one or a job? A struggle with depression or substance abuse? Or is it the struggles we face as a nation as we walk among the dead bones of truth in our public square, as we worry about the death of our democratic values? How do we hear the call to prophesy to those bones? Perhaps grief, loss, anxiety, financial troubles, or a lack of faith has put us in our own tomb of despair. A long time ago, in a far-off land, Jesus stood outside that tomb denial and of death, calling us to new life right here, right now. So what are those tombs for you, for your family, for this community of faith? In what ways do you participate in what God is doing today in your midst? In what ways are you helping to bring new life to a hurting and broken world? Are you helping to unbind those who have died? How many of us have known the feel of those strips of cloth, the grave's apparel, the shroud that keeps us wrapped up in a leaden existence and makes us long for the release, for the light of day and the feel of fresh air in our lungs? What strips of cloth are binding you? What feelings of hopelessness and loss have caused you to lose hope? Christ is calling you out from those places, is telling you to come out of those tombs of despair, to unbind the claws of addiction, worry, of stress, to unbind the claws of poverty, hunger, homelessness from this community, from our world, from those who suffer needlessly. Christ is speaking to us as people of faith to be those who help to unbind, to bring to life and to resurrect those dry bones. Lazarus, come out. Dry bones, wake up. Come out from the graves that we have dug for ourselves, to come out from those places of fear and darkness, come out from all those hiding places of addiction, of substance abuse, of depression, places where things can fester and deform, and to come out into the light of God's love, to rebirth beauty and joy and faith and hope in the Lord Jesus Christ. How can we, as people of faith, be the unbinders, be the resurrectors of dry bones? Jesus is calling us to be that light in our world, to bring that change and that new birth to a hungry and hurting world. May it be so. Amen.
Amen. Amen.